So we have two Kujaku of breeder Maruhiro in this bowl. And what we will do in this video is discuss the Kujaku variety. And Kujaku are koi that have a white base with orange, reddish markings on it. And in their scales, it is typical that they have darker gray, yeah, kind of black scales on the white skin. And it looks like a net pattern, which is really making this koi a nicer and more special variety. These kind of black scales you can also find on the Matsuba variety. And sometimes you will see that on this variety, the orange can almost become red. And when it becomes red, it is referred to as a red Kujaku. So of course, when you want to select a Kujaku, you always want to imagine, like, how is this koi going to look like in the future? Because usually you just don't buy a koi for today, you buy it for a lifetime. And for that reason, you want to make sure that it will develop even nicer in the next couple of years. So what I will do in this video is try to explain you with some examples on what aspects you want to look for when you select a Kujaku. So what we will discuss in this video is the Kujaku in detail, about the pattern, the head section, the body posture, and also why you really want to have light scales when the Kujaku is young. So let's first talk about the pattern. Now, what you will basically see in the Kujaku is that you have to pay attention to the kind of Kohaku pattern. So Kohaku is the white koi that have a red patterns on it, red steps on it. Here we can replace the red with orange, and then actually we are looking towards the same aspects as for a Kujaku. So for example, is one of the elements is you want that the red or the orange is not covering the eyes. So as you can see on this Kujaku, is that actually the orange is laying over the eyes, so that's not so preferred. And that is also happening with the other Kujaku. You can see that the red or the orange is laying over the eye on both sides, so that is not so preferred. The best thing is that the orange stops in between the eyes. And then the second aspect is same as for the Kohaku, is that also for Kujaku we prefer that the tail section, the last part before the tail, so the odome, this area here is white. So this one is a little bit better, but still the last part is orange. We prefer it to be white. So actually what you want with a good odome is that the orange stops around here and that the last centimeter is all white. And honestly, I do have to admit that these two Kujaku are not like really high quality. They are the two best that I was able to find for now. And really good enough to explain you all the details about Kujaku and also indicate like which spots do you have to look for, which aspects of the body do you have to look for. So for this video, it doesn't really matter what Kujaku I'm using. But yeah, like I said, these are both not state-of-the-art Kujaku, surely not show winners. But yeah, good enough to explain you all the details. And this Kujaku is a good example of paying attention towards the lateral line, because you want that the orange is laying actually on the back of the koi. And the lateral line, if this was the koi, is like the middle, the side, middle section, and you don't want orange below the lateral line, you only want orange above the lateral line. So this koi actually has that fairly good. As you can see, the bottom is all white on both sides, but the other Kujaku, let's see, yeah, actually it is also quite good. You want it to be, yeah, above the lateral line, as I said. Maybe it's a little below here, but that's fine. Something else is you preferable have no red in the fins. So this fin is really good. Other fin is a little bit of orange in the core of the pectoral fin, that is not so preferred at all. Something else is in the pattern, you don't want any gaps. So with a gap, I mean, so this is a nice orange Kujaku. If it had a gap, for example, that would mean that in this orange section was in the middle a white round spot. Or it doesn't have to be round, but at least a white spot. That is, well, circled around it with orange, and that is not so preferred, so you don't want any gaps in the pattern. And just like with Kohaku, you also want Kujaku to have a nice pattern, and preferable that is a multi-step pattern. So this Kujaku is, well, almost two-step. This is one orange step, and this is one orange step. Preferable, of course, it are smaller steps, smaller dots of orange. Same with the other Kujaku, also two-step, really big step. And then the tail also is a really small step. And yeah, to have that a little bit more balanced and a better pattern would be to have multi-step with wide sections in between it. Of course, you want a balanced pattern, so on the left and the right side, the heaviness of the orange pattern should be about the same. So this Kujaku actually is balanced. As you can see, the heaviness of the pattern is well divided over the entire body of the fish. So that is good. About the head, for a Kujaku, normally it is really nice if it has white and orange on the head. So what I personally don't like for this Kujaku is that the entire head is orange. It is really, well, if you have a good Kujaku, you will see that the head section is really, really intensively white. It's crystal white. And that is also what you have to pay attention for. You want the area on the head should be really white. And what happens a lot is that in the middle of the head, so between the eyes, like in this area, sometimes there's black visible. And if that black is visible in the white area, well, I would not consider to buy that Kujaku, because usually it's not really a good indicator, and most of the time this black will become even more intense over the lifespan of a Kujaku, and probably you will end up with something like this. If you look at this Kujaku, you can see a lot of black on the head, and it doesn't look so clean. So you want a nice, crispy, clean Kujaku head with white on it for sure. Of course, as with any koi actually, you want to make sure that you buy a koi with a good body posture. And it all starts with a torpedo looking, so a straight body. You don't want, for example, a belly visible. You want the body to be smooth, straight. Then you also want a long head. The tail section, you have to pay attention to this area, that it is quite width, and also that the height of the tail is good. You don't want a low tail, basically, because that is an indicator for a weak tail, and also an indicator for slower and weaker growth. And I do have to mention that, of course, you can look at the aspects for a good body on a Kujaku. That is important, because when it grows larger, you will see that a Kujaku with a good body will look way better, way more massive, more imposant. But you also have to take into account that Kujaku usually don't reach the, let's say, 80 cm. I've only seen a few Kujaku in Europe that reach the length of over 80 cm. Most stop at around 65, 70, maybe 75 cm. That really is mostly the maximum size. The last part is about the scales. And I mentioned before that Kujaku tend to have like Akamatsuba scales. And when you look at this Kujaku, you can see that even in the orange, there's like black visible underneath the koi. And if you have a really good Kujaku, and yeah, like I mentioned before, these two, well, both are not really, really good Kujaku, but you can see that on each scale, there's some black visible. And usually in the core of each scale, the black is more intense. And what you want to make sure to do is, for example, this Kujaku, you can already see that the black is kind of becoming intense. The other one is a little bit lighter. And what you want to do is, when a koi is young, like this, you want that scales to be as light as possible. Because when they are dark already at this age, that is, yeah, usually in harder water, which we mostly have in Europe and America as well, the black really develops quickly. So what you will end up with is a Kujaku with too many well, two intensive dark spots on it. And that's not really something that is appreciated. You want only the core of each scale to have the black visible. So far about the Kujaku variety. What I can also do in the future is do a selection video if you would like to see that on selection of Tosai Kujaku. Like, what aspects do I look for when I'm selecting these? If you would like to see that, please let it know in the comments and I will make sure that that video is coming up shortly after this one. If you did enjoy this video about the Kujaku variety, make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel, because in that way you will make sure that you stay up to date with all new upcoming videos in the near future. So of course, thank you again for watching and see you in my next video.